we were here for a long time, and even the Camiguinians, we've known that there are shards, battle shards on the beaches, but we don't know anything about sea glass. Not until 2 years ago, we have a guest, Kokoy. Don't you know that you have so many sea glass on your beaches, and it's very expensive in New York and in Europe? You go online and do your research, try to collect them. So that's how we started. I made some research how to make some simple jewelry. So we gather the women, we do programs for schools and also for women. We'll try if we can make this as a livelihood program and more training for our women. So that's how it started. So it's all just tumbled by the Kenaging Smoothen, tumbled by sand, rocks, and then the waves.
Yeah.
That's why it took a certain time bago siya talaga masmoothen yung broken glass.
Years, no?
And more or less 30 years just a study. This kind of glass you can date because it was only manufactured during the 1800s, 1700s, when transport in the sea doesn't have refrigeration. So they have to make really dark and black glass to protect the liquid, the wine, and the medicine from sunlight. But you do like that, Mom says. You can see the color.
Yeah, humus, this one.
There is a grading system for sea glass. So grade A are those which are already perfectly shaped by time. No more scratches and no more cracks. And the grade B are the ones we use for handicrafts with a little, just a little, what do you call this, imperfection. The value of sea glass is according to color. The most common colors are white, green, and brown. While the rarest are the red, yellow, and orange in the world. To produce red glass, you need to have gold oxide to make it a red color. That's why it's expensive to make. These are all garbage on the beach that we also collect. So these are like toothbrush holders, bottle caps. So we collect anything, lighters. These are just bottle caps. So this one also, all the things you can find, the different kinds of sea glass, including tiles, Chinese ceramics. So we also collect sea pottery, which is also quite common. So we have plenty around the island. We make them into artwork and at the same time, some handicrafts. Of all the people in Philippines, and then of all the people in the Camiguin, we were the ones who were being introduced to sea glass. Then it could have been like other people, but it was us. So maybe it was really us, because maybe we have the capacity to gather people, to empower people. I think that's the reason probably why it really came to us, landed on us. Well, that we have this treasure, we have this, like we call it a gems in the island, which nobody ever like discovered.